got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite when they're coming to take your freedoms away.
All right, doing a little Rage Against the Machine so that you too can know your enemy. Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. You know, I've been spouting off for a long time telling you folks that, you know, get the picture, the system doesn't work, your voting is just, it's foolishness, it's ridiculousness, it doesn't, this country is screwed, it's failed the third time now. They haven't told you it's fully collapsed, but it is. If every individual, including the baby out of the womb, owes $52,000+, the system has collapsed. Now, about the third major time, and maybe it just was collapsed from the beginning. Because as I go through this financial timeline, to give you guys something to grab a hold of so that you'll see that this is the real deal. From the beginning, this has been a fallacy, a fraud, and a control by the England. Okay, you had it. When we got here, we had it. Sovereign states, individual states, and everybody lost their fucking mind because they had no more control. So we form what we think keeps us free, a constitution, and pull us all back together as one entity, the United States, on paper. And you think that you're free and sovereign, and you're not. And what they know is that they just took a separated group that could have kicked their ass at any moment if they acted together, and pulled them into one unit and controlled them by systematically sucking them dry repeatedly. Anyway, I started going through my notes, and I only got up to 1865 before I just got so pissed off and irritated. I mean, the picture is so clear to me, people. But I know you need more than that to take any action. You have to be fully sure of what has happened and what should happen. And so the goal in this is to get everybody to see that we need to go back to separated states that just have a common agreement that we're going to occupy this land and we're going to work together for the betterment of everybody, the protection, but that this system is a complete fallacy, okay? And we need our governors should be the body in Congress and the president. They should be replaced by the 50 governors. Okay, that will return power to the people, and it will give every state individual say on an equal basis. And no law would be passed that affected the whole group unless the whole group saw fit to pass that. And if the 50 governors passed a law that was against the people of their state, they would have to come home and answer to those people. Right now, that nobody has to go anywhere, and nobody has to fucking answer to anything. It's bullshit. Anyway, I want to point out a few things, and I'm going to link you to this website that I got this information from, because there's a whole lot more that you probably want to know about. But anyway, let me touch on some of my notes on this timeline. So basically, even before it began, 1785, it failed. There's a major depression because of unstable paper money. Note, unstable paper money. Now, I know that's not a clear statement that all paper is unstable, but, well, again, you owe $50,000+, and your baby that just was born does as well. And so anyway, okay, 1786, Board of Treasury condemned paper currency, okay? The revival of a paper currency and the rage for another experiment in this fallacious, that means false, that means fantasy, fallacious medium that has so far prevailed as to enter into the system of revenue of several states. Paper currency. Fallacious medium. Okay, keep that in mind. And again, you owe $52,000 plus. Haven't checked in a week. It may be 53,000. Excuse me if I'm wrong. 1787, during the Federal Convention, Robert Sherman made the statement that no government has the right to impose its subjects any foreign currency to be received in payment. Okay, foreign currency. Look at the dollar bill in your pocket. You're convinced that that's your money. No, look at it. Look at it very closely. Do you see anything that might tell you that it's a foreign currency? That it's not your money? Well, how about right at the top of the fucking thing where it says Federal Reserve Note? Federal Reserve. That's not a United States. Wait a minute. Where? Oh, they put a building up here or there, probably on our land, and make us pay for that as well. But it's a foreign government or foreign entity. Okay. It's illegal. No government has the right to impose its subjects to any foreign currency. The money you carry in your pocket is a foreign currency. And the only reason it stays there is because you allow it. Continue on. See, I'm getting pissed off already. That's why I only made it to 1865, folks. Okay. Hopefully you have more patience than I do, and if you need a little help, you'll go to the links below and do some more research. Okay, so here we go, moving on. 1789. First Congress of the United States was convened in New York, marking the beginning of government under the Constitution. So this is basically where it began. But before it started, it was a fallacy. Okay? Before it even started, it was a fallacy. So then we get a loan. Started right off borrowing money. Never had any stability, did we at all? No. Right from the beginning. Once they herded you all back into the sheep pen, they needed to borrow money right from the beginning, okay? And supposedly this loan was the only loan negotiated without the authority of law. Well, again, I say that's bullshit, because we're borrowing money daily, and we the people are the authority of the law. According to what you have been told, and you should be, but you're really not, okay? Because we're still borrowing money, and nobody asked me if they could borrow money to bomb children in foreign lands to steal their oil or whatever their other motives are. No, nobody asked me to borrow money to pay our soldiers to go guard drugs that I'm not allowed to take. Anyway, moving on. 1790, Treasury Secretary Alexander Hamilton says the United States should pay its debt at par value, even though speculators would profit by this. A footnote, Alexander Hamilton married into the Rothschild family. It has been reported that there are documents in the British Museum that prove Alexander Hamilton received payment from the Rothschilds for his dastardly deeds. So right from the beginning, folks, Rothschilds in our government, influence of the Rothschilds, England's money in our government, in our system, and only our system because we allow it to exist. Again, I mean, anyway, let me move on. I may be losing you. Let's see here. Bank of the United States, 1791. Bank of the United States is chartered. The first president was a Navy captain, William Jones, who had no banking experience and who had just gone personally bankrupt. Also blamed for the Panic of 1819. So we start our very first bank with somebody that knows nothing about banking and has gone bankrupt. This is how we start here. We're only at 1790 and we've already collapsed before we started. Borrowed money before we got going. Have a bank that the president washes, you know, dishes for a living. I don't know what the fuck we were thinking, but anyway, I wasn't there then. Well, that lasted a long time, didn't it? 1811. Closed. 20 years. That's how good that system was. 20 years. So then we just wait a few years and we do it again. Okay. Open up a second bank of the United States. The bank suffered from serious mismanagement and outright fraud. 6 years, you know, now you have to wait, what, 7 to 10 years? No, we only waited 6 years then. So see, again, we're only at 1817, and we see all this, the money's a fallacy. Everybody in control is tied to England. We borrow money we don't have, nor do we need it. Okay, all we did was form a government. All that is a bunch of words on a piece of paper, and suddenly we owed money? You explain to me how and why. Explain to yourself, because, again, I understand that the paper is a fallacy. Refer to these notes and other stuff. Let me move on. Here we are. President Lincoln approved Secretary of Treasury's plan to create the United States Secret Service. One of Lincoln's last acts, Lincoln was assassinated by John Wilkes Booth. I wanted to point out that had ties. The other four men involved in the assassination apparently linked to the Rothschilds. Okay, because of the greenbacks. That was supposed to be our money. 1865. Public debt of the United States stands at over $70 per capita. And Secretary of the Treasury Samuel Chase hoped national banks would replace state banks, creating a uniform currency and fund the Civil War. Okay. Does that make any fucking sense to you at all? Okay. Create a bank. Create a fallacious currency to fund a war. We're only at 1865, folks. Look out your fucking window today. Look in your newspaper. Look at the headlines. We're still creating currency, printing it daily to fund war. And in the meantime, we're creating another coming civil war because they've got everybody divided. But when in reality, we should have stayed divided as sovereign states. I don't know. The picture to me is very, very clear. Okay? We have to take some responsibility ourselves. We're self-righteous, greedy whores as people. We are. And that's why they're allowed to do this. Okay, you're not going to come shovel the snow out of my driveway and allow me to give you a chicken so that you can go home and feed your family. No, you're not going to do that. You're not going to do things like that. See, because you don't want to create anything anymore either. You want to consume. You know, if you want that newest iPod, here's a fucking suggestion. Learn how to make it yourself. Take some of the control back. And I know, so you can't build everything. We need some medium to trade. But it doesn't have to be a piece of paper with ink on it controlled by a foreign entity that we pay to. Well, what are we paying them for again? Do you have a printer in your home? And if not, can you afford $50, run down to Walmart? Okay? No, and I don't support Walmart, but I'm just saying. The service they're providing is, they're a printing company, folks. They're a printing company. Your money has no value. We're only up to 1865. Like I said, I got so pissed off with just this amount of information. And I'm pissed off because it's so clear to me, and I don't understand why you, the American people, don't see it. Now, I know there's a lot of other factors, but I'm going to assure you that when you actually take the time to research all those other factors, I only made notes from this, you're going to see that it's worse than even I'm presenting it to you. And if you can't see that, I don't know what to tell you, okay? I don't know what to tell you Oh, one more thing I wanted to tell you about D.C. Okay? It was established by the Constitution of the United States to serve as the nation's capital. You might have known that. Right here. We had, again, the choice of Washington's site along the Potomac and Anacostia Rivers resulted from compromise between Alexander Hamilton. Remember, in the notes, Rothschild. Rothschild, okay? Alexander Hamilton. Alexander Hamilton married into the Rothschilds family. The creation of the thing that you believe in so much. You believe in D.C. so much. That's my country. That's where my politicians are. And if I just vote a little different this year, it's all going to be fine. Right from the beginning, a complete fucking fallacy. Still under the control of a foreign entity, and you still don't get it. You still think voting is going to do it. Now, I know the elections are 4 years away. Why are you worrying about it now? We got through this one because I started a year before this or 2 years before this election trying to tell people that the voting system doesn't work. The system we have in place in this country doesn't work. In these notes, we never even got up to the Great Depression, right? We never got there. We didn't touch on it on the statistics of today, how many people are on welfare and government programs and how many people are homeless and how many empty houses that are sitting there. Did you know that there are twice as many empty houses as there are homeless people? And that if we would just all, you know, actually do our share and not just pay to have our share done for us, that we could house everybody and we could feed everybody and we could take care of ourselves and we could be a United States. But we are not a United States right now. We are so divided. And why? Why? Because that's the way we were supposed to be. We were supposed to be divided. But we're not divided on paper. We don't have any sovereignty left. We don't have any. We don't have anything. We don't. Did you look at the debt clock recently? Let's take a look at that. Where is it here? We'll get it for you real quick. U.S. debt clock. Here we go. Let's take a look. You can see I check it quite often. That's why it's highlighted. You understand that. Okay, no, you're still at 52,000, but on the better half of it. So it's, you know, another 300 and change, and you'll be at 53,000. How soon till your baby's born? Another 3-6 months. You pregnant now? Your wife pregnant now? Because in a few months, your child's going to owe $53,000. Anyway, the links to this resource will be below, folks. Go through this. There's a lot of information. If you need it, to actually get off your ass, and I don't know how we get out of this, but my thought is that we have to individually, state by state, force our governors and the sheriffs of those states to march on Washington and take this country back. It needs to be dissolved, and we need to reconstruct, and it's going to be painful. And the critical thing here is when we finally get enough of us to understand that this needs to happen, we also need enough of us to be willing to give what we have left, and it's not a lot, to support those that have nothing now. Because when this happens, the little bit that they don't have, that those few trickles of dollars they get from the government every month to feed themselves and their children, is going to go away. And those people are going to not be able to feed themselves, not be able to clothe and house themselves. We must be willing to take up the slack and help them within our states, in each state, work together. I know it's not as simple as that. I can't do it, obviously. I'm no fucking hero. I don't have all the answers, but I know this system doesn't work. I know it's a complete fallacy. And I know that if you don't do something about it now, this country is going to... we're going to have civil unrest and killing anyway, and it's going to be our own government doing some of the killing, and the people will be killing the people. Get ready. Get ready. Do something. Much love. Many thanks. Links will be below.
And you've got to put your bodies upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers, upon all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop, and you've got to indicate to the people...